now to see that two climb bottles are, we can put two predictive planes together to get a climb bottle. So this is kind of a lens.
Can you explain how to glue two surfaces? What is two projective planes?
So, okay, so this, well, here is a simple example of two surfaces glued together. These two surfaces are glued together by a dead about here. But let me draw another picture of the Klein bottle. Okay, now what I'd like you to do is do the following cut. So this.
If they don't understand how to glue two surfaces.
So
a sphere and a sphere. What is the result?
So glue just means if we've got a gluing diagram.
No, no.
Just
if we have two different spheres, can we glue them?
So you're now you're talking about connected sum. I'm not talking about connected sum right now. So you can glue two spheres by cutting out a disc from each and then identifying the edges.
Ну, а проективные плоскости, как я их склею? На самом-то деле...
So one way to show that two things glue together to give another thing is to start with the big thing and then cut it in two to get the two smaller things. That shows that it's the result of gluing these two small things together.
Надо взять две поверхности и приложить их маленьким кружочком. И этот кружочек вырезать. И это и будет склейка. Понятно, да? То есть, вот смотрите, кулак к кулаку прикладывается, и в то место, которое совпало, его вырезают.
So now that we're reasonably confident with gluing diagrams, I'd like you to take the Klein bottle, and I'd like you to make the following cut. Two cuts. Okay. So I'd like you to cut this line and this line. Okay, so get two pieces, or in fact, in your paper you have three pieces. But if we just examine what I've drawn here on the Klein bottle, so here's the whole thing is the Klein bottle. Whole thing is a Klein bottle. Inside the Klein bottle, what have I drawn? What does the blue describe? What surface is that?
It's ignore the Möbius.
This is the Möbius. So inside the Klein bottle, we've seen a Möbius strip, and that's going to be later. If you take the Möbius strip, so this Möbius strip, take that out, and we're left with these two pieces. What I'd like you to do is cut this out so that you can put these two together. So I cut. I've got my Möbius in the middle, and now I've got these two edges. Make this cut. What I'd like you to do is glue this rectangle to this rectangle and tell me what you get. And then we're just going to remember they've got some further identification. So this is on the Klein bottle. So this point here on the Klein bottle, where on the square does this point get glued?
The
top right. So this point here, let's call it the side C. Side C, that's getting glued with this side C, and as we go on this way, call that D. That's getting glued with this side going the other way. Okay. So what I'd like you to do is put these two rectangles together and tell me what you get.
So
Pardon?
Cylinder?
No. Well, let's see.
So then
it might help you to cut out the pieces to see.
Ребят, надо обязательно в тетрадях нарисовать эту картинку. Просто в тетради. Не надо ничего резать пока. Просто в тетради обязательно нарисуйте и подумайте, что бывает, когда верхнюю треть приклеивают к нижней трети.
So when I actually cut this, I'm asking you to cut it, not re-glue this time. So cut it out, so your one piece is the blue, and the other piece are the green. And like you tell me, what is the green? So what happens when you put these two together?
Yeah, please, give them some time to draw.
Yes.
D to D? Yeah?
Yes.
Максим, это реально надо нарисовать? И понять. Нет, и результат после склеивания, когда D с D склеиваешь, надо тоже нарисовать. Должны быть две картинки. Не будет никакой точки.
Смогу ее уменьшить.
У тебя в центре осталась лента Мёбиуса. Это такая, да, средняя полоса. Это лента Мёбиуса. Верхняя и нижняя надо склеить. Получается один кусок. Было три куска, станет два. Замечательно. Что такое вот этот склеенный из верхней и нижней? Можете нарисовать его?
Ну,
на доске. Нет. Можете выйти нарисовать?
Да.
Вот сейчас увидим.
So, Ульяна, can you tell us which, where is this?
А внизу тоже буквы.
На исходном чертеже нет ничего.
In this rectangle, is that rectangle? Now, what have we got? B. Oh, let's draw one from B. Boundary and D.
This actually looks like a projective plane.
So you got these two sides. How can we deal with this? So we've got this edge.
It's projective plane.
How can you see it's projective?
No, Maxim, it's not just a projective plane. It's a projective plane with a cutout. It's different. Because there is an edge over there. You see? Из проективной плоскости можно получить такую же штуку,
как?
Только снизу нету этого.
Не понимаю.
Легко по диагонали.
Стрелочки неправильно стоят. Не так, как надо. Я ни по-русски, ни по-английски уже не понимаю ничего. С этим я вас всех поздравляю.
Wait, let me just try to do something. Because, you know, when you made that mistake with... I mean, this thing looks almost like a projected plane. Because you see, if we get...
A crumble. Ah, sorry.
No. If we get a projected plane, and if we cut it like this, it gets into... A shape like, well, I'm not totally drawing, but it gets into a shape like this. And that one looks, and if we add an edge instead of this point, so you see, this one, a projected plane can be drawn as this. Gluing mask, and if here we add a side, Then we get the same thing as there.
And what does it mean to add a side? How do you...
To cut a hole, actually.
Oh, okay.
If we cut a hole in the... Because you see, we can glue these two sides together, and then we get a kind of head. Where this one is glued to this one. But then we add a side here, so we make a cutout.
And so Andrew made a really great observation.
Извини, one second. Андрей, теперь то же самое по-русски.
Плоскость можно разрезать и снова склеить вот так вот. Это понятно?
Да.
Это то же самое, что вот это вот. Но я просто переместил это, совершенно для удобства. Дальше вот эти вот две стороны можно склеить так, что мы получим цилиндр.
Круг.
Вот так. Да. Но тогда вот тут...
Почему цилиндр?
Ну, не цилиндр, конус.
Конус.
Конус, да. Мы получим конус. Но вот эти две стороны будут склеиваться вот таким образом. Вот эти две стороны будут склеиваться вот таким образом. То есть это сложно себе представить. Да. А потом мы добавляем вот сюда вот.
Отрезок.
Вот этот вот отрезок. Вот эту вот сторону. То есть, соответственно, вместо точки у нас отрезок. Поэтому вот он. Вот эта грань. То есть это вот то же самое, вот это вот. Понятно?
Да.
А вот эта штука это край ленты Мебиуса, который придет.
Shape has one edge, and this is the same edge of Mebius strip. And when we add the Mebius strip, we'll get the.
Yes, that's right.
Ульяна, вы сейчас поняли, что Максим сказал? Не поняла. Excuse me. Максим, еще раз то же самое по-русски для Ульяны.
Мы доказали то, что вот эта вырезка, это есть на самом деле такой цилиндр, у которого усеченный цилиндр, у которого вот этот вот...
Усеченный конус.
Да, усеченный конус, у которого...
В котором нижняя сторона склеена странным образом.
Нижняя сторона склеена отчасти как проективная плоскость, а верхняя это просто граница. Вот. И вот эта граница это самая грань ленты Мёбиуса. Потому что когда мы склеим, мы получим бутылку клея.
Ну смотри, если поворачивать из этого же сумку, у нас же вот эти красники, это граница тоже ленты Мёбиуса. Но то же самое, что вот эта голубая часть. Ну, а это голубая часть, это то же самое, что вот это вот.
Так, у вас вопрос, Дарья. У вас есть вопросы?
I can try and I'll speak slowly in English to summarize.
Yeah.
We took a coin bottle, we cut out a Möbius strip, we cut this out, and we were left with two pieces. And when we glued those two pieces together, we got this interesting looking thing. And we're wondering, what is this?
What is this?
And Andrew made the observation that if we start with the projective plane,
Начиная с проективной плоскости.
And if we cut out a disc,
и вырезаем диск.
Cut out, вырезаем.
Okay, so we're going to cut out this disc.
Диск это круг.
Then we get something that looks like.
В общем, что-то выглядящее.
Cut out that disc.
Принципиально важный момент. Пожалуйста, без ошибок заново нарисуй то, что он сейчас нарисовал, две картинки.
Take the projective plane and Andrew suggested we cut out a disc, then we get a new polygon with an extra side. So that's what Andrew suggested. Cut out a disc and that's how you get an extra side on your polygon. So if we redraw this, then we have it with a polygon with five sides.
Yeah.
Получаем пятиугольник.
If I call that K, then I have a side K. A. Okay, and so that's, so let me draw, let me draw this guy. This had five sides. Okay, and is this the same as this guy? Oh, the labeling is different, isn't it? So here's K. I'm just gonna relabel the A's and B's and D's and the arrows so it looks like that. Let's see, how should we go? Maybe that could be D. D, D.
Так, ребят, он меняет буквы, чтобы картинка совпадала бы с той. Но от перемены букв ничего не изменяется.
You should have started not with the projected plane, but with another, with a different image of the projected plane.
You see an image, more convenient one?
You started with this mm-hmm. image, while I did it with this one.
Okay.
And that's why it's not going to be the same one now on your drawing.
So we can't relabel them to get that? Is that what you're saying?
No.
It looks like you're right. So, okay, so let's do it. Andrew, now that you've seen this way, could you take your guy and cut it like this for us?
So we cut it like this, and we get something, and then we can transform it so that it looks like this is the K side, the A's are actually the D's, so we remark this side D.
Вместо буквы А написали букву Д.
And we don't need to do anything with B sides. So now you can clearly see that this is the same as this.
Okay, so wine bottle, cut it, and maybe a strip. And we get this. Projected plane, cut out a disc and get that. So, climb model minus Möbius. It's the same as taking a projected minus a disc. It's what Andrew did. Put the projected plane, cut out a disc, and we got that. Which is the same as what we got when we put the climb model. And we cut out a Möbius strip. Okay? But still, we're left with the question, what is this? I think earlier we claimed that this was the Möbius strip. So we were talking, the discussion before. So the claim is that this is the Möbius strip. So if you take a projective plane and cut out a disc, let's see, let's draw the projective plane again.
Если вырезали лист Мёбиуса из бутылки Клейна, то получилось то же самое, что проективная плоскость с вырезанной дырочкой. Вы это поняли или нет? Если вырезать, это он показал слева на картинке, вырезать лист Мёбиуса, да, вот эта средняя штука, лист Мёбиуса, то тогда остается по сути, то же самое, что проективная плоскость. Так? Больше пока ничего не произошло. Хорошо.
Okay, so maybe we have another question for you. What happens if we do the same thing, if we cut out a Möbius strip, not from the climb bottle, but if we do it from a projective plane? Okay.
Что будет, если вырезать лист Мёбиуса из проективной плоскости?
And this is a good explanation. Okay, so I'm going to draw the Mobius, the Brinkner plane. Okay, and I'm going to draw a Mobius strip inside it. Let's do. And I'd like you to put these two pieces together again. So we'll do the same thing here. That was the little climb bottle. So we get a Mobius strip with these two rectangles. How are these getting identified? So where's this point here? This point here. Where is this going to? Can you hear that?
Right edge. Top right.
Top right, okay, so A. And, oh, excuse me, not A, it's C. C, and is C going up or down?
Down.
Down. And let's do a D. Okay, so I'd like you to, in the middle of the movie strip, so forget that, I'd like you to put these two together and see what you get.
That's a disc.
So it will come something like that, so a boat.
That's a disc. Это диску.
Я умею это объяснять совсем просто, что такое проективная плоскость. Это поверхность нашей Земли, где любые две противоположные точки – это одно и то же. Понятно?
Да.
Замечательно. А теперь представьте себе, что я иду вдоль экватора, и километр вверх, то есть на север, и километр вниз, то есть на юг, я беру такую полосу. Представили? Отлично. Вы понимаете, что эта полоса, это как раз и есть лист Мёбиуса? Отлично. А теперь надо про южное полушарие просто забыть. И остается шапка северного полушария, это и есть тот самый диск. Поняли? Все.
Would someone like to explain to me why this is a disc? Let's fix this one and draw this one next to it.
Yes. This is a D facing upwards. This is a B.
C, B. Mm-hmm.
Facing left. This is a C facing downwards. There is another C facing downwards. Here.
Okay, so now Andrew's flipped
yes.
This guy over.
Then here D is facing upwards. And B is still facing right. So if we glue that together,
okay, now
we get just
разве так?
Да так.
Бэшка же снизу так же.
Нет.
And now this is actually a disc. Because we can glue these two, and then these two. Well, I mean,
конус получается.
Ариана's boat.
Yes, we get. А как сказать конус по-английски?
Это будет
cone. We get a cone, and a cone is actually the same as a disc.
Mm-hmm.
Topological.
Ульяна, поняла?
So. And just more generally, if you just want to stick with this, if you have a diagram, And if you have two edges, so here B and B, ignoring the rest, if you have two edges like this, then notice that's the same as if I drew it like, so let me do these dotted. And then you have the rest of the diagram. Okay, now I'm just going to push that down. So that B is going out. That B is going out. You see that? Just push that, drag that thing down, and you get this picture. You see that? Okay, and now you can see that that red, those two arrows can get lined up. Okay, so that edge has been eliminated from your diagram.
Очень важная вещь. Если есть в одной точке в противоположных направлениях два ребра, то на самом деле их можно просто отбросить.
So in a gluing diagram, whenever you have two edges going in the same direction out of the vertex, then you can erase that those two edges. You just squeeze these two bits together. So, maybe a concrete example. So, in this example here, if we did it here, we have okay. These two edges are coming out the same direction. So we can rub out that edge and glue this edge to this edge. That's what we're saying over there. Okay, so we're going to rub that this edge out and identify the two ends. Okay, and so we put D and D. We can do the same thing with this one. So, that's more clearly Andrew's cone, so maybe it's best to stick with that. Andrew's cone equals this. I don't want to rub that extra bit out. Okay, so we're seeing that Klein bottle minus a Möbius, but band, is the same as a projective plane minus a disc. Okay, but we've also seen that a projective plane and minus a Möbius band. And what order do we get when we cut a Möbius band from a projective plane? We got our disc. Yeah. So if you take the projective plane, cut out a Möbius band, you get a disc. So therefore, if you start with the projective plane and you still cut out the disc, so P equals disc plus Möbius.
P — это проективная плоскость.
So if we start with our projective plane and we cut out the disc, Nikolai, what are we left with?
Möbius.
Yeah. Okay, so we've discovered some interesting things. You take the Klein bottle, you cut out a Möbius band, you get a Möbius band. That's the same as if you take a projective plane and you cut it a disc. Okay, so there are all these interesting manipulations you can do with gluing diagrams just by the cutting and re-gluing. Okay. Here's another thing I'd like us to think about.
What about two projective planes?
Yeah. Okay, so here... Alright, so let me finish this. Honestly, before I meant to write down Möbius strip instead of projective plane, so it threw me off. But there's two projective planes.
Yeah. Итак, все-таки как же доказать, что две проективные плоскости – это бутылка Клейна?
Okay. So what I'd like to do is to start with a projective plane, two projective planes. Now, remember, how can we draw this with a using a polygon with two sides? I want to draw a polygon with two sides. And if I start with an arrow here, can you guys remember how to, what, if I draw an arrow, I won't draw the projective plane, okay? If I have an arrow going this way, which arrow, way should the arrow be going here? The opposite way. So that's going to be, that's also a projective plane. Okay. Okay, so now, let me check, although I've got really
Еще раз, ребята, проективная плоскость. Okay. So, проективная плоскость получается, если вы берете круг и склеиваете его противоположные точки. Режем по диагонали.
Cut along the diagonal and re-glue. Okay. So we kind of done, we did it before. So what I'm going to do is just cut along the diagonal and don't re-glue along the new side. So we're going to cut. Okay. Now we're not going to re-glue because we want to cut the thing. So cut so that you get two new sides. Okay. And so this is what we did this before. So I'd like you to glue this A to this A and tell me what you get. Okay.
Склеиваем по букве А.
Well, this one like to draw. So we did it before and then we glued. So, Nicola?
And this, and A, B, and this.
Excuse me, Максим.
Please, Максим.
You started. Good, it's like when we... Эта штука то же самое, что... Вот такая штука, где вот это. It's like the same. When we get another one, то, ну, вы говорили правило, что можно взять, посчитать вот вот эту границу десятилетия и получим противоположное направленное две штуки, которые это и есть бутылка Клейна, потому что ее можно вот так вот засунуть внутрь.
Замечательно. Теперь Андрей тоже сам по-английски.
Okay. He says that if we get two cones, well, because what we get from this is actually a cone with this mark of bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And if we get another one and put it like this, then we can cut this part of this cone. And this
Андрей, part собой загораживайте, пожалуйста.
And then we'll get something like this, which is basically a cylinder with opposite edges glued with a flip. So it's a Klein bottle.
Okay, so where do we see the two projective planes?
This is a projected plane with a cutout. And this is another projected plane with a cutout.
So what we've kind of what I realized is this is a difficult, well, before we look at the problem of climb bottles being two predictive planes, we should talk about what Andrew describes here. So Andrew said we glue two predictive planes after making a cutout. So in other words, you cut out a disc from each and then you glue together. Okay, so it's a little bit complicated. Particularly when you're on non-oriental surfaces. So let me draw a picture. So before we do this, we would really need to talk about the kinetic sound.
Он наконец-то дает определение, что такое сумма поверхностей.
Okay, and that's so originally I meant to write Möbius band, not vector plane, because this is, and the reason is because this is more advanced. So I think I'd rather leave this to next week because it's quite complicated. But the idea with the kinetic sum of surfaces is you start with two surfaces. So here it was kind of complicated. We start with two projective planes and then we're gluing them together. But the idea with what we call the kinetic sum, it's a strange name. It means start with two surfaces. For example, what is this called?
Yeah.
Torus. The idea with the kinetic sum is you cut out a disc from each. Okay. So cut out a disc. Okay, and then you glue those two discs together along the boundaries.
Все понимают, что в каком месте вырезать не имеет значения. Потому что вы можете сдвигать эту дырку по поверхности, и в смысле топологии ничего не будет меняться. Поэтому в любом месте вырезаете маленькую дырочку и склеиваете по этим дырочкам.
So cut out this disc and just glue those two edges together. Okay. And so there's a new surface. And whereas the torus head, how many holes does a torus head? Whatever hole, whatever you think hole.
Wow.
And now how many, glue two together and how many holes do I have now?
Two.
Two, okay. And so let's do just one more and then I'll leave you with some homework. So this is just a warm up. But if we took a torus and we took a sphere, take a torus and a sphere, and we did their kinetic sum. So we move a disc here, and we move a disc here, and we glue it together.
So what do you need means?
It's a torus.
Glue it together.
Потому что вырезать дырочку и сразу ее заклеить, это то же самое, что ничего не делать.
Torus in a sphere, so the symbol is kinetic sum. What do we get topologically? What is this thing? So firstly, how many holes does the thing we have
one
now?
And it's a torus.
It still just has the one hole. Okay. So notice that the sphere, it's like you take a torus and you just imagine it's made of a balloon. Balloon and you suck some of the air out of the balloon. That's the same as push that down and we get a torus again. Okay. And alright, so I'd like to talk a bit more about the kinetic sum. So let me just end with some homework for you, exercises. And some complicated diagrams today. So firstly,
Так, народ, просьба реально сделать домашнюю работу. Запишите, пожалуйста, все И, пожалуйста, ну давайте, курс хороший, поэтому давайте серьезно отнесемся к этому, пожалуйста.
So, on the Bloom diagrams, for the sphere, the torus, Langevin, Möbius, and printed plane. How many corners are there? How many distinct corners? Distinct corners are there. So draw a glue diagram and count the number of vertices.
Это у нас готовит калибр характеристики, ребят. То есть посчитать количество вершин, ребер и граней. Но пока он говорит только о вершинах. Ну, смысл понятен, да?
Какой-то.
А? Уголок.
And also,
вершин, на самом деле.
How many corners are on these?
Он хочет подготовить вас к идее Эйлера характеристики. Ну, разумеется, надо понять, что будет после склеивания. То есть надо вершины обозначить буквами так, что те, которые склеиваются, это будут одной и той же буквой обозначены. И посчитать, сколько разных букв. Понять, что это за поверхности.
Oh, and also there is only one B on the middle.
B.
Oh.
A, C, B, A. C, B, A. And I'll give you one more. Last one. So that's homework I like to play with. So how many distinct corners? So is this is this corner, does this corner appear anywhere else? And next week, we'll talk about the connected sum again, and we'll turn to the question of gluing two projective planes to get a climb board. Please come up to me if you have a question.
Какие углы?
Корни.
Так всегда дай, спроси.
Не в лично угла, в смысле самого вершины.
Количество штук.
Ладно,
ответь. Надо ставить точку А. После этого смотрите, куда она склеивается. Везде там ставите А. В другую точку ставите Б. Смотрите, куда она склеивается. Там везде ставите Б.
Вот, например, у Торы сколько точек?
Одна. Потому что там они все склеиваются. Все четыре вершины квадрата реально склеиваются в одну точку.
It wasn't actually a question for you because Alexander Zilich already answered. Maxim asked how to count corners distinctly.
Maybe we should start,
but Alexander Zilich already answered.
Okay. Well, I can join.
Maxim gave an example of a torus, and Alexander Zilich told that it has only one corner because all four corners of the square are glued to the same place.
So I'd like you. That's to think about it as opposed to just be told the answer. So if we look at this corner here, so this arrow going up means that this point is glued to this point. This point here is glued to this point. On the other hand, this point here, because this arrow is matched with that arrow, this point is also matched with this point. And now this arrow going the same as this arrow, which means that this point is also identified at this point. Okay, so this point is the same as this point. And so the question is, on each of these, how many are there? So this only is one pair. Torus is one pair. One distinct. Distinct means they aren't glued together when you do the glue. Is there any other question? Okay, thanks everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.